Hello, in this video we will see mirror formula for concave mirror, concave spherical mirror. Even though it is possible for us to have concave parabolic mirror or even for other shapes, we are only considering concave spherical mirror. Now this is the concave spherical mirror. We want to get the mirror formula. The mirror formula is this: 1 by f is equal to 1 by v plus 1 by u. We have to derive it. In this, f is the focal length of the concave mirror, u is the distance of the object from the pole of the mirror, v is the distance of the image from the pole of the mirror, f is the focal length, and we are going to follow new Cartesian sign convention, okay, in this case. So to draw the image, it's enough if you have two rays, two reflected rays minimum required to draw the diagram of an image. Now you can see here, A1, B1 is the object placed beyond C. We are doing the derivation when the image formed is real. Okay, even though you can do the derivation for the virtual image, first we'll do this. So object is beyond C, A1, B1 is the object. You take two rays. If you take more number of rays, the diagram will become more complicated, confusing. So take two rays. One ray is incident on mirror and it comes back obeying law of reflection. This is angle of incidence, this is angle of reflection, they are equal. Angle B1 PA1 is equal to angle B2 PA2. Because of law of reflection. What is this law of reflection? I is equal to R. What is I? Angle between incident ray and the normal. What is the normal here? CP is the normal. Angle between the incident ray, this ray, and the normal, angle of incidence. I wrote here as I. Angle between the reflected ray and the normal, angle of reflection, R. They are equal according to law of reflection. Another ray passing through the center of curvature retraces the path. That is, again, because this ray is incident along the normal, the ray will get reflected, the ray will be reflected back in the same path. The ray retraces the path because it is incident along the normal. So the two rays we have chosen. You can even take other rays also, but not necessary. Okay, so B1 PA1 angle of incidence, B2 PC angle of reflection, B1 PA1, B2 PA2. Okay, now we will see how to proceed. Take similar triangles A1 B1 P, comma A2 B2 P. A1 B1 P this one and A2 B2 P this one. These two triangles are similar. Why? This angle 90, this angle 90. This angle is equal to this angle, I is equal to R. Third angle will automatically be equal. So the two triangles are similar. Therefore, A1 or A2 B2 by A1 B1, use the property of similar triangle, will be PA2 by PA1. Corresponding sides are proportional. Then these two similar triangles, that is A1 B1 C, A1 B1 C and A2 B2 C, are similar. Here again 90 and 90, these two are vertically opposite angles, they are equal. Therefore, these two triangles are also similar. Here you have A2B2 by A1B1, A2B2 by A1B1, A2C by A1C. Equation 2. Compare equations 1 and 2. Left sides are equal. Correct? Therefore, right sides should be equal. So, PA2 by PA1, should be equal to A2C by A1C. But better to express all distances in terms of the distances from the pole of the mirror. Okay? So A2C is PC minus PA2. A1C PA1 minus PC. A to C, PC minus PA2, A1C, PA1 minus PC, correct. Now use the symbols U, V, F with the due sign convention, new Cartesian sign convention. PA2 minus V, PA1 minus U, PC minus 2F minus PA2 minus V by PA1 minus U minus minus 2f, give sign convention. So here also negative symbol, here also negative symbol, you remove it. So here it will be equal to v minus 2f by 2f minus u. That is v by u is equal to v minus 2f by 2f minus u, cross multiply. V into 2f minus u is equal to u into v minus 2f. Expand. 2fv minus uv is equal to uv minus 2fu. Okay? Got it? So, proceeding further, I just write here. This is uv. This is minus uv, this is uv. Take this to the other side, 2uv. This is 2fv, this is minus 2fu, bring it to this side. 2fv plus 2fu. So this 2 you can cancel. Divide throughout by uvf, fv, divide by uvf. You will get 1 by u plus fu divide by uvf, you will get 1 by v. Uv divide by uvf, you will get 1 by f. Therefore, 1 by f is equal to 1 by u plus 1 by v, or you can even say 1 by f is equal to 1 by v plus 1 by u. This is mirror formula. Okay? Yeah. Next, we will define the expression for magnification. Next, we will see what is meant by magnification. Next is magnification. Magnification, here we are taking up linear magnification. Linear magnification also, here we are taking lateral magnification. We are not bothered about angular magnification right now. Linear magnification, that too lateral magnification, because there you have also what is known as longitudinal magnification. We are not considering it here, only lateral magnification. The definition says M is equal to H2 by H1. You can say this is H2, that is A2B2, that is image size. It is defined as the ratio of image size to object size. Definition of magnification is the ratio of image size to object size. That is H2 by H1. H2 image size. H1 object size. Okay. Now coming to the similar triangles, or you can even consider this. Already we proved it. So A2B2 is minus H2 because inverted image. A1B1 is plus H1 because upright image. Sizes measured from the axis up positive, sizes measured from the axis down negative, new Cartesian sign convention. Therefore, right side what you have, PA2 minus V by PA1 minus U. Therefore, H2 by H1, this will become plus V by U. So, minus H2 by H1 is plus V by U. So, H2 by H1 minus V by U. Therefore, magnification M is minus V by U. So, we have derived mirror formula. 1 by F is equal to 1 by V plus 1 by U. Also, we derive the expression for magnification. M is minus V by U. Understand that? See, magnification numerically greater than 1 means enlarged image. Equal to 1 means same size image. Magnification numerically less than 1 means diminished image. Right? Magnification is negative means inverted image. Magnification is positive means erect image. Understand that? So this is mirror formula assuming the real image being formed. Sometimes they also ask derive the mirror formula or mirror equation using the formation of virtual image. So later on we will see how to apply these things to solve numerical problems. Okay?